Hi, I'm Vivian.
And I'm Arthur.
And along with Candace, we're your hosts for What's New with Microsoft 365 this month. Right now, Microsoft's Ignite conference is happening down in Orlando, Florida.
Yay, Ignite!
Yay! Woo. But today is actually the first day of the conference, and it goes on throughout the entire week. So we thought we would kind of change things up a little bit here this month, and instead of doing our usual updates, we would cover all the major announcements that are coming out of Ignite.
Right, and one of the major announcements has to do with Microsoft Teams. So new capabilities to enhance collaboration and business processes for all workers are in Microsoft Teams now. Things like private channels, multi-windows, and new messaging extensions let users customize their Teams conversations and experiences. To help people easily manage tasks, conversations, and files from other Microsoft 365 apps, we've also deepened Teams integrations with Outlook, To-Do, and Yammer. These new features make it quick and easy for first-line workers to securely access Teams from their mobile device.
Next up, big news for Microsoft Edge and Microsoft Search. The new Microsoft Edge streamlines access to both your work and personal files. With the Enterprise New Tab page, you have direct access to Office 365 files, sites, and internet search, making you instantly productive with every tab you open, which sounds way more productive than the usual random 37 tabs I have open in my browser. And with the new Microsoft Bing, searching for information at work is now as easy as searching for your favorite chili recipe on the web. You can now access personally relevant files, people, and company info from across your Microsoft 365 ecosystem without leaving your Edge browser. The new Edge is now available on all your devices and PCs. Candace had a chance to talk to Bill Dahl, who worked on the new Office mobile app before he left for Ignite. Let's see what she found out.
Hi, so I'm here with Senior Product Marketing Manager Bill Dahl, and he's here to talk a little bit about the new Office app. So what can customers expect from this?
The Office app is a whole new mobile experience for the phone from Microsoft. You know, we kind of think about the existing apps that are out there with Word, Excel, and PowerPoint, and they were really originally designed for computers and PC-based experiences, and then, you know, altered in order to make it work well on a phone. This really reimagines that whole experience and comes with the forefront of, like, what would a productivity experience that was designed for mobile in the first place look like?
So you mentioned tasks. What are some common tasks that customers will now be able to do with this new app?
Anything that somebody would do today with Word, Excel, or PowerPoint, they can do on their phone. So there's no need to relearn an experience. There's no concern about which features are missing in this app that are in those other apps. So immediately people should have a pretty good idea of what they can get done. But as you said, we've integrated some really cool actions as well. So whether that's moving files between devices, using scanning QR codes, creating PDFs, and signing PDFs, you can all do that from this one experience. And so it really helps tie everything together so that you don't have to jump around between apps.
When it comes to Office and productivity, what are some advantages that customers can see from this app?
Now with the integration with the camera, you're able to take a picture of a document, whether that's a standard document full of text or even a table, and the app will automatically convert that into an editable Word document or Excel document. It's an amazing experience, actually, once you see it and do that. It really is a big time saver. Even people like my wife, who, you know, doesn't really use apps like this too much, she's like, wow, I can totally see how I'm going to use something like that. And so it's really a big time saver. And one of the things we found with some of our early users is that's one of the difference makers that really stands out to people.
Awesome. So we've talked a little bit about what it is, what it does, but kind of curious to know what your favorite new feature is.
Yeah, so there's a sticky notes integration where, you know, sometimes you have a quick idea and you're when you're on the go, you're moving between things, you can't really think about, all right, if I'm gonna open OneNote, which file or tab do I, or which tab do I wanna put this on? Like, I just go in, I can just do a quick note, it's just kind of like sticky notes on your phone, and you can come back to it later and take care of it when you need to. You don't have to think about where you have to go.
Ignite's coming up, you're gonna be in the sunshine. I wanna know what the thing is that you're most looking forward to.
Well, I'll be honest, I'm really excited about going to Universal Studios. Okay. Last year was the first time I got to do that and see Harry Potter World and all that. My kids are super jealous of me right now for doing that. They think that's all I'm doing down here. But to be honest, one of the things that also really stands out to me is the opportunity to meet and talk with customers. Sometimes it's even just sitting around at lunchtime and just striking up a conversation. But I find those experiences to be super valuable in thinking about what I do at work and how I do it. And so I can't wait to have more conversations like that.
Yeah, and you get to be in the sunshine, so I'm a little jealous of that. Yep. But thanks so much for taking the time out of the day to come talk to us.
Thank you for having me.
Yeah, so we're back to you.
If you want to check out the Office mobile app, it is now available in public preview today.
In Excel, we're introducing scripting with Office Scripts, a new feature that allows you to record your actions inside a workbook and save it to a script. A saved script can then be integrated with Microsoft Flow, enabling you to schedule it to run automatically or integrate it with a larger flow to accomplish process automation. Office scripting will be available as a public preview by the end of this year.
Candace had a chance to sit down with Pete Dodurko and talk about the new Power Platform integration within Teams.
Hi, I'm here with Pete Dodurko, and he is a senior product marketing manager here, and I want to talk a little bit about Power Platforms. So tell me a little bit about how Power Apps has been integrated into Teams.
Sure. So Power Apps is actually already a really powerful integration with Teams. Power Apps creators can go ahead and put the apps right in Teams where their users are already working and using them today. Mm-hmm. We're making a couple of updates to Power Apps to make it even easier and more discoverable for users. So for example, Power Apps creators can now publish those Power Apps directly as Teams to make it even easier for their users to find and then access those apps. Additionally, users can take those apps and pin them to their left rail of Teams so they can go ahead and use them wherever they are, wherever they're working, kind of agnostic of the channel that they are working on.
Awesome. And tell me a little bit more about how Power BI is being used.
Yeah, so Power BI is a really great and powerful tool for making sense of data. And when you can actually match that with conversations, it becomes even more powerful. So we're taking Power BI and putting them directly into conversations that users are having today. Coming soon, Power BI will be able to put an adaptive card directly in Teams so that you and I will know exactly what report we're talking about and having conversations about, and it'll be very clear what actions we're supposed to take, whether that's opening in Power BI or subscribing to the particular report.
So it sounds like it's really helping productivity.
Yeah, absolutely, and helping productivity and helping users make better data-driven decisions.
Awesome. And what about Power Automate? How is that helping with productivity?
Power Automate is helping users really streamline their productivity scenarios and workflows. Putting that into Teams really takes advantage of the conversational nature of Teams. So we're working to really expedite and streamline the conversational and team-based processes that everyone has to face. Mm-hmm. And so there's a couple of new features that are being added. Now users can actually trigger a flow that is based off of a new member being added to a team. Mm. So I can use that to create a really welcoming environment, add you to the team, introduce you to everyone, and also share some very important information to help you ramp up even more quickly.
Yeah, it sounds like it's a new way to communicate more effectively with your coworkers.
Yeah, it's great. It's streamlining processes, and it's really helping with the cultural transformation as well.
So Ignite is coming up, and we're all a little bit jealous you get to be in the sunshine. But I want to know what you're looking forward to most.
Aside from some vitamin D, my favorite part of my job personally is working with customers and chatting with them. And so I'll have a great opportunity to talk with a number of customers, both that I've met before and haven't met at Ignite, just to see what they're working on today, what they're using Teams and Power Platform for, and you know potentially what we can work together on in the future.
Awesome. Well, I'm really jealous that you're going to be there. But thanks for taking the time out of the day to talk to us. And
yeah, of course.
It's really great to know what's been going on with Teams and Power Platform.
Of course. Thank you for having me.
In security news, Microsoft Compliance Score is now in public preview. This measures your progress in completing recommended actions to reduce risk around data protection and regulatory standards. We've introduced new assessments for the California Consumer Privacy Act and other GDPR-style regulations. So I heard that 53% of companies have experienced an insider attack in the last 12 months.
Oh, really?
Yeah, it's kind of crazy, actually. But with the Insider Risk Management solution, which is now in private preview, this is really going to help organizations identify and remediate insider risk. How it works is that it leverages the Microsoft Graph and third-party signals like HR systems to identify hidden patterns and risks that traditional or manual methods might miss.
More new stuff with Microsoft Endpoint Manager. It converges Intune and Configuration Manager functionality and data, plus new intelligent actions. It offers a seamless end-to-end management solution without the complexity of a migration or disruption to your productivity. Look for Microsoft Endpoint Manager features and experiences to appear in the product over the coming months. Our customers tell us they want to improve their security posture by scoping what admins do to only what they need to do their jobs. Global Reader gives admins the ability to view, look up information, and report on their environment without requiring global admin permissions.
Our customers have also been telling us they want best practice guidance from Microsoft about what they should be doing next in their environments to improve security and administrative efficiency. In the Microsoft 365 Admin Center, we're delivering AI-powered recommendations that unify signals and deliver recommendations across Microsoft 365, including AAD, Security Center, and Compliance Center.
Office 365 Groups is the membership service that drives teamwork across Microsoft 365. It's a core underpinning of Teams, SharePoint, Outlook, Power BI, Dynamics CRM, and other applications. We continue to improve groups with new group lifecycle management and compliance capabilities, including teamifying a group, restore deleted groups, edit group email alias, and sensitivity label support. IT admins can enable self-service group creation, which lets users do things like create teams and Yammer channels with guardrails and policies set by IT. At Ignite, we're announcing other major innovations in Microsoft 365 for knowledge management. For example, new innovations in Microsoft Search to help people understand acronyms, automate QA, see their building's floor plan, and extend search to third-party apps.
And lastly, new self-service experiences in workplace analytics help leaders identify ways to improve employee experience, organizational agility, and customer focus. If you're at Ignite, let us know in the comments and share what's the coolest thing you're learning or seeing at the conference.
Yeah, and as always, just hit us up with your feedback. And if you're not a subscriber, what are you waiting for? Just hit that subscribe button.
And we'll see you next time.
Bye.
So now that you've watched this video, don't forget to check out the Microsoft 365 blog that has a little more detail about what we went over today.